Okay, lots to talk about, Rita. It was a big week. What happened this week? Anything out of the ordinary?
It's a quiet week for me. landslide's the key word there. This is a clean sweep. I don't think even you, in your most optimistic moments.
Landslide, yes.
Did you think it was going to win every single swing state? Single swing state. Gave him six. Everything. The House is the only thing that we're still waiting confirmation on. He's edging closer and closer. He's got the Senate. He's got the popular vote. And, of course, he's got the all-important Electoral College vote. So this is an enormous mandate. It is undeniable that the American people have spoken, and they've spoken clearly. And the swamp better listen, because it's going to be very different to Trump's first term. That first term, I think there was he was a little bit naive about just how vicious.
Key point, how different this Trump agenda is going to be. Trump 2.0, James. Mm. You're in New York City there. Tell us about it.
Well, yeah, I'm in New York City. As you can hear, people outside are celebrating. It's Saturday night. I'm sure they're all out here celebrating Donald Trump's victory, because what else would there be to party about on a Saturday night in New York City? But I can tell you, though, New York City, which is, you know, typically very, very Democratic, even that, the five boroughs here had massive swings to the Republican Party, had massive swings to Donald Trump. And you talk to people just on the quiet, you find that people are, there's so many more Trump supporters out there who are willing to say it than you would have ever seen in 2020. And even, I would say, in 2016. 2016, you know, was one circumstance. 2020 is a whole nother case, you know, story. But this here is a real mandate. As you said, Rowan, you know, the House is looking likely. The Senate is done. All the blue wall is gone. Many states that were very Democratic have started to move more Republican. All sorts of demographic groups have started to move more Republican. This is a huge mandate here. And the big key then is, what's going to happen next? And the key thing here is, well, who is Donald Trump going to be bringing in as staffers? I'm hearing that Mike Pompeo may be Secretary of Defense. I'm hearing Richard Grenell may be Secretary of State. Those are a couple of names I can share with you that are being talked about very widely in Trump world. But also we see that Donald Trump himself is coming out and announcing all sorts of policies on all sorts of things, from, you know, transgender kids to the media and social media censorship. So I think they've got a better idea this time than they did in 2016 or 2020 about how the levers of power work, what they need to do. And I can tell you also, they've had their own private transition team working for months before the election. So they don't have to rely on the government to help them do the transition. They're going to do it themselves. And that's going to give them a huge advantage.
I think they've learned not to rely on the government for anything after Donald Trump nearly got shot thanks to the failings of the US government. Trump has been president, James and Rita, for only a handful of days. Wait for it. The stock market has already hit a record high. Bitcoin hit a record high. Migrant caravans at the border have been dissolved.
President-elect.
Hamas has called for an end to the war. Really, Bitcoin, as I said, record high. Putin ready to end the Ukraine war. Qatar, we'll talk about this, Rita and James, has kicked out the Hamas leaders. Whoops, get rid of them. EU will now buy US gas, not Russian gas. Putin will sell oil in US dollars. Zelensky has phoned Trump and Elon. Whoops, hello, mate. Yep. New York mayor ends his vouchers for illegals. Mexico to stop migrants at the US border. China wants to work peacefully with the US, and big US companies are big US companies moving out of China. It's big stuff, Rita. I mean, he's already, just the thought of the Trump 2.0 of the next 4 years has got the world moving in the right direction.